Good morning, students. Already we have discussed with the previous session profit and loss appropriation account. So here, for the preparation of profit and loss appropriation account, the main intention is to ascertain true profit or loss for the year ended. So in this session, we will solve some questions as per the PU board question bank. So already in the last class, I told. So here in the second chapter, question bank, page number 24th, question number 2. In that question bank, page number 24, question number 2, all of you observe the question. So here, the question, Shiva and Basava are partners. So in this business organization, there are two number of members in a partners, sharing profits and losses in the ratio of 2:1. So in this business organization, there are two partners in a business. Both the partners are sharing profits and losses in the proportions of 2:1. This is what profits and losses sharing ratio. And with the capitals of rupees 25,000 and 15,000 respectively. So here, one of the partners, they are investing 25,000 rupees and one more partner, they are investing rupees 15,000. So here, the first person, Shiva. Shiva is investing rupees 25,000 to the business. And the same being, Basava, he has investing rupees 15,000 to the business organization. This is what contribution of capital by each partner. So here, interest on capital is agreed at 6% per annum. So this is what very important at the time of preparation of profit and loss appropriation account. What is the rate of interest on capital they are getting? So here, each and every partner, they are investing some capital to the business. So for that capital, they need to get interest. Annually, they are getting 6% interest per annum. Per annum is nothing, PM is nothing but annually, they are getting 6% of interest on their capital balances. Then, Basava is to be allowed an annual commission of rupees 1,500. So here, Basava is allowed an annual salary of rupees 1,500 rupees. So here they are getting annual salary only. They give it directly annual salary of rupees 1,500. Suppose they are getting 1,500 rupees per month, means on that time we need to multiply for that number of months. But as per the details in this question, directly they give an annual salary to Basava rupees 1,500. So this is what Basava's salary. Next, a provision of rupees 2,000 is to be made in respect of commission to the manager. So here, each and every business organization, some incomes as well as expenses, this is what normally. So, in this business organization, they are giving annual commission to manager. Commission to manager, this is what expenses to the business. So, the commission we need to record in the debit side of profit and loss appropriation account. Again, so here a provision of rupees 2000 is to be made in respect of commission to the manager. Interest on drawings. So, after that, commission of managers. So there is an interest on drawings. Interest on drawings by each partners already they are calculated. So here Shiva's drawings are 1,500 and Basava's drawings are rupees 1,000. So this is what given information. Now we need to prepare profit and loss appropriation account. So here at the time of preparation of profit and loss appropriation account, first we need to draw a format for that account. First, headline, profit and loss appropriation account. So in this question, they are not given assessment here. So they give us at the end of the assessment or at the beginning of the assessment, on the 10th, they need to record specific date. So as per the question, they are not specified at what date they are preparing profit and loss appropriation account. This is what format for preparation of profit and loss appropriation account. So in this account we can record few transactions. In the few transactions means in the credit side we can record profit during the year and interest on partners drawings. Only two transactions we can record in the credit side. On the same thing in the debit side we can record interest on capital, salary, commission. These much of transactions we can record in the debit side of appropriation account. Okay, so shall we start in this question? So first of all, in this business organization, there are two partners in a business. So here, the partners are namely already we are discussed in the question. Shiva and Basava are partners. So here, in this question, at the end of the year, what is the total profit? At the end of the year, the total profit of rupees 10,000 rupees. So here, the total profits we can record in the credit side of appropriation account. First of all, here appropriation is nothing but distribution of profits or losses in the business. The first transaction we can record in the credit side by profit and loss appropriation or profit and loss account. So as per this question, the total profit for the year rupees 10,000. This is what? Total profit for the year. So here this transaction we can record by the way of by balance drawn down or by profit and loss account or by net profit we can record on any similar word terms. So here after the recording of profit and loss account, again we need to record whatever the adjustments are given in the question, that adjustments we need to record now. So again come to the question, Shiva and Basava are partners sharing profits and losses in the ratio of 2:1. So here 2:1, this is what profits and losses sharing ratio. And with the capitals of rupees 25,000 and 15,000 respectively. This is what invested capital to the business. Here interest on such capital is agreed at 6% per annum. This is what second adjustment regarding preparation of profit and loss appropriation account. So here interest on capital we need to record in the debit side. So here the second transaction to interest on capital account. So in this business organization there are two partners. The partners are namely Shiva and Basava. Now we need to ascertain total interest on capital. Already they given total capital invested by each partner. Whatever the capital invested by the each partner, that capital we need to take for that calculation of interest. So here Shiva, he has invested rupees 25,000. Shiva, he has invested rupees 25,000 and Basava invested rupees 15,000. Shiva invested rupees 25,000 and Basava he has invested rupees 15,000. So here, as per the details, so now we need to calculate interest on this capital. So here the interest, the rate of interest on capital is 6% per annum, 6/100. So here 25,000 into 6/100 means we will calculate rupees 1,500 rupees. This is what interest on Shiva's capital. The second one, Basava's interest on capital 15,000 into 6/100. 15,000 into 6/100 means we will get rupees 900. If you have to calculate once again. 25,000, this is what total capital of Shiva. 6%, this is what rate of interest on capital. 25,000 into 6% means we will get 1,500. Again, Basava's capitals are 15,000. The rate of interest on capital, 6%. So, for the calculation of 6% out of 15,000 capital means we will get 900 rupees. This is what interest on capital by each partners. So, as per the detail in this question, we have recorded two different transactions. The first transaction, it is related to profits for the year. The second transaction, it is related to interest on capital. For that calculation of interest on capital, this is based on their invested capital only we are calculated. Again, observe the question. The next one, Basava is to be allowed an annual salary of rupees 1,500. So here, Basava is an active partner in the business organization. Basava has allowed a salary, annual salary, not monthly salary. They are allowing annual salary of rupees 1,500. So in this transactions we can record in the debit side. So here the salary of Basava's is to be rupees 1,500 to Basava's salary. Basava's salary account. What is the salary of Basava? As per the given adjustments, they are allowing 1,500 rupees. 1,500 rupees. This is what annual salary to Basava. The next transaction, the next adjustment, it is related to. So here during the year 2015-16. This is what assessment year. In this assessment year, they earned the profit of rupees 10,000. In this assessment year, they earned profit of rupees. Already we are recorded in the credit side. This is what total profit. Whatever the total profit during the year, that profit we need to record in the credit side. First, we need to record whatever the profit in the business, that profit we can record in the credit side. Again, continue the question. A provision of rupees 2000 is to be made in respect of commission to the manager. So here, they are allowing commission to the manager. How much commission they are allowing? Rupees 2000 rupees they are allowing commission to manager. The commission, this is what expenses to the business organization. The expenses we can record in the credit side. Debit side. So this transaction we can record in the debit side to commission to manager or manager's commission account. As per the detail in the question, the commission to manager rupees 2000. This is what? Annual commission to manager. Again, continue the question. And interest on drawings being Shiva rupees 1500. So here interest on drawings we can record in the credit side by interest on drawings account. First of all, in this business organization there are two partners in a business. So here both the partners there is an interest for such drawings. So here interest on drawings only we can record in the credit side. So here the first person, the first partner is Shiva. So for here the Shiva's interest on drawings will be rupees 1500. You have to record in that inner column only. And the same being the next partner Basava, and Basava rupees 1000. Both the transactions we need to record in the inner column only. Now make it total. So here 1500 plus 1000, total balance 2500. So here in this question, as per the detailed, we have recorded all the transactions. Now we need to balance. So first check it, which side is more. So for that, ascertainment of profit or loss on appropriation account means, first of all, we need to balance. At the time of balancing, we need to observe in the both aspects, debit and credit side. So as per this question, so in the credit balance is more. As per the given transaction, the credit balance is more. The total credit balance 12,500. Make it total. This is the total credit balance. The credit balance you have to transfer to debit side. So here the total credit balance is more compared to debit balance. The total credit balance you need to transfer in the debit side. So in this 12,500 you have to deduct all the transactions. You have to deduct all the transactions in the debit side. So here 12,500 minus 1,500 plus 900 plus 1,500 and 2000 rupees. So all these transactions you have to deduct. After that deducting, the differentiation amount 6600. This is what remaining balance. This balance we need to appropriate among the partners according to their ratios. So these 6600 we need to transfer to partner's capital account. To partner's capital account. 6600, this is what remaining profit during the year. These profits we need to appropriate among the partners according to their ratios. The ratios are given 2:1. This is what distribution of ratios. So here we need to appropriate these profits among the partners according to their ratios. The first person, Shiva. Next partner, Basava. So here, the remaining profit 6,600. This is what remaining profit in the business organization. These profits we need to appropriate among the partners according to their ratios. Their ratios are available. The ratios 2:1. So here Shiva, they are allowing one more partner. They are getting 1, 2+1, 3. So 3. This is what total profits in the business. Now we need to take out 2+1, 3. 2/3. So here one of the partners Shiva, they are getting 2/3 of share in the business. The next partner, they are getting 1/3 of profits in the business organization. So here 6,600 × 2/3. Now we have to calculate 4,400. This is what is share of profits in the business. The next person 6,600. This is what total profit 6,600 × 1/3. You will get 2,200 rupees. Both the balance we need to record in the debit inner column only, in the debit side of profit and loss appropriation account. So here 4,400 + 2,200 means we will get 6,600. This is why total profits in the business, that profits we are distributed among the partners according to their ratios. So once again listen the question. So in this business organization, there are two partners in a business, namely Shiva and Basava. Both the partners are investing some capital to the business organization. The capital might be, one of the partners, Shiva, he has investing rupees 25,000. One more partner, he has investing rupees 15,000. This is what capital, whatever the capital contributed into the business. And in this business organization, they are getting interest on capital at 6% per annum. Per annum means annually they are getting 6% of profit on out of their invested capital in the business. And the same being in this business organization, the Basava partner, they are getting annual salary of rupees 1,500. Suppose Basava is allowing rupees 1,500 per month means, suppose some adjustments are maybe they can ask. So they are getting 1,500 per month. On that time we need to multiply the total number of months in a year. But as per this question, Basava, they are allowing annual salary of rupees 1,500. The next one, commission to manager. Annual commission to manager, this is why 2,000 rupees. And next one, finally, in this business organization, the partners might be, they can withdraw some drawings from their business. On such drawings, they need to pay interest. So here, interest on drawings, this is what income to the business organization. That's why we are recording in the credit side. So already we are recording total profits for the year rupees 10,000. This is what total profit. And the same being, interest on drawing, this is what income to the business. So here Shiva, they are allowing 1,500 rupees drawings. Basava, they are paying 1,000 rupees interest on drawings. So here both the values we need to record in the inner column and make it total. So here the total balance 2,500. So now already we have recorded all the transactions in this question. Now we need to balance. So here compared to both aspects, means both the debit and credit side. So here compared to debit balance, the credit balance is more. So 10 plus 2500, 12,500. This is the total profits in the business. So these profits we need to transfer in the debit side. The total 12,500. So this is the total profits in the business. Out of these profits, we need to discharge all the liabilities, all the expenses in the business organization. So here, interest on capital, salary, commission, these all such transactions are expenses to the business organization. That's why we need to deduct from total capitals in the business organization. So here, after the deduction of all the expenses, the remaining balance 6,600, this is what remaining profits in the business. So these profits, we need to appropriate among the partners. We need to appropriate among the partners according to their respective ratios. So these profits we need to distribute among partners. So here two partners capital account. So here partners are namely Shiva and Basava. So here the total profits in the business 6,600 into 2 by 3 means 2:1. This is what profits and losses sharing ratio by partner. So 2 plus 1 3, 2 by 3 means 4,400 rupees we will get. This is why Shiva's share of profits in the business. Next, Basava. So here the total profits in the business 6,600 after the calculation of all the transaction. That 6,600 into 1 by 3. So 1 is the share of Basava. So 1 plus 2, 3. 1 by 3 means we will get 2,200 rupees. This is what share of Basava. So 4,400 plus 2,200 means 6,600. These calculated balances we need to record in the inner column only. So this is why preparation of profit and loss appropriation account. First of all, here appropriation means the thing, but distribution of profits among the partners according to their agreed ratios. So here, as per the PU board, this question. So this is what solution for that question number second. So in this, in the next class, we will discuss the next question. The next question is third question. So here, on the third question, the method was same thing for the preparation of profit and loss appropriation account. We need to discuss it in the next session. Thank you.